All right, ladies and gentlemen, today we're going to be doing a video on the reasons why atheism and atheists are absurd. Now, the definition of atheism is the same as absurd. Impossible to take seriously. Silly. Synonymous with foolish. Notice, foolish. And I have here, in my formerly Bible page turning fingers, seven reasons why atheism and atheist are absurd. Let's go with reason number one. Atheists believe there is no intelligence. This is what they say. They say there's no intelligence behind the creation of the universe. There's no intelligence behind the creation of you and them. And therefore, luck and chance created all humans and the universe. Well, then the atheist must say that this motorcycle is the product of luck and chance. Because if humans are a product of luck and chance, and the universe is a product of luck and chance, you tell me, atheist, you tell me how intelligence gets smuggled in to your atheism. See, I was thinking about something. I used to be an atheist, but I left atheism because it's absurd. In fact, you cannot ground reason and intelligence on atheism because atheists believe that they came from a rock, all by luck and chance. Do you know that atheists believe that non-life created life? Now, a lot of atheists will incorrectly say evolution created life. Evolution is not a creator of life. Every time you atheists say evolution created life, I go to your YouTube channels and your kids. You know, 95% of the atheists here are kids. I go to their channel and they got anime and Minecraft and all this stuff. So they're kids. But for you adults like Matt Dillahunty, it's time to grow up. For you adults like Aaron Ra, Cosmic Skeptic Alex O'Connor, Godless Engineer Thunderfoot, the entire cast of the Atheist Experience show are fools, according to scripture, and according to science and biology. I am going to prove beyond a shadow of any doubt, you're 100% going to agree with me that atheism is absurd, because here is the list. Let's go through it. So number one, remember, the definition of atheism, the word absurd, is foolish, impossible to take seriously. Number one, atheists say that they don't believe in God, and they're a presuppositional atheist. You know what that means? A presuppositional atheist means you have no evidence, you have no arguments, and you start off with the flawed, brainwashed mindset that atheism is true automatically. Even though there's no evidence, there's no arguments for atheism, you mess up atheists by starting off as a presuppositional atheist. This is why debates are so great. When you go into a debate, you must prove your side. Well, atheists have been trying to disprove the existence of God since the beginning of time, and no atheist has been able to do it. So let's get on the motorcycle and ride. And first, let me go through the other six things that we're going to talk about while we're on the motorcycle. Now, atheists really believe that this motorcycle is the product of luck and chance. They have to say it. They're committed to saying it because they themselves, they claim, are a product of luck and chance. And atheists, evolution didn't create you. Evolution is not a creating force. You guys got to get this through your skulls of mush. Evolution talks about how things change after they're created. Evolution doesn't create. You got to get that through your thick, mushy skull. So number two, the atheist says, I don't believe in God, therefore there is no God. Oh, atheist, this is just madness. it's, what's the word we're looking for? Absurd! Just because you say you don't believe in God, atheists, that does not magically make God disappear. That's not even an argument against the existence of God. So you've got to quit doing such absurd things. And, you know, we're going to talk about that, how I'm going to prove to you that the atheist does know God exists, but they are suppressing the truth in their unrighteousness. Atheists say that they're good. They say that they're good, that atheism's good. I am going to prove in this video that atheists, you are more evil than Hamas on their worst day. That's right, Hamas, that brutally murdered and raped and killed children. I'm going to prove to you on this video that atheism has murdered well more people than Hamas. They make Hamas look almost like amateurs. Atheism is the number one murderer and rapist of people in the world. We're going to go through this. I'm going to prove it to you. I mean, you atheists make Hamas look like amateurs. So atheists say they're good, but that's not true. As a matter of fact, if you go to www.shockofgod.com and you listen to our latest radio show, I go through all this on the radio show also, but atheists say that Christians are trying to change laws when in fact it's the atheists that are trying to change laws. There were 56 signers of the Constitution. 54 were Christians. There were 250 founding fathers. All but 12 were Christians. This is called an education, atheist. Educate yourself on the founding of America. It is the atheists that are trying to change the laws of America. They are atheists that are trying to change the foundation of America. And we're just about to get on, but let's go through the other ones here. So, now, atheists say they don't believe in God, but you wouldn't know it because they spend most of their time bashing God. They always bash God, but they never bash Satan, their daddy. You ever notice that? All types of atheist videos, but not one of them is bashing Satan. All of them are bashing God. Let's see what else. Now, atheists are all talk, no action. I constantly get atheists saying, I'm going to call into your radio show and I'll answer the Shock of God challenge. The Shock of God challenge is, what proof and evidence can you provide that would finally at last prove that atheism is accurate and correct? And no atheist has been able to do it. Because atheism, as you know, is not about reason and intelligence. Remember, the atheists believe they were birthed by a rock. So there is no reason and intelligence on atheism. In fact, they use evolution. Evolution doesn't lead to intelligence. The evolutionary force is not a system that leads to intelligence. It's all about survival. So, you atheists, seriously. So, you're all talk, no action. You have no proof and evidence. You're scared to answer the question, what proof and evidence can you provide that atheism is accurate and correct? You're terrified to answer it. And you guys wussed out on the last radio show. I had at least 7 of you saying you were going to call into the show. None of you called in. You chickened out. And you were listening. I could see you guys listening to the show. It shows where all you guys are listening from. Now, they will say that humans came into existence through evolution. Remember, we talked about this. Evolution is not a creative force. So they'll say, well, I meant abiogenesis. Well, let's tell you about the problem of abiogenesis. But first, ladies and gentlemen, check this out. This is awesome. There's only one solution, atheist. There's only one solution, you guys. Only one person in world history lived a sinless life. Only one person in world history has proof and evidence that they died and raised from the dead. Only one person in world history did that, Jesus Christ. Now, why did Jesus do it? Well, if you take a look at this, we are separated from God because of our sin. We were condemned because of our sin. And if the atheists say, well, I don't believe in sin, that's also a sin. So add that to the list. But the good news is, Jesus Christ does not discriminate. He died so atheists could go to heaven. He died so Muslims can go to heaven. He died so everybody can go to heaven. Yet Jesus said, few will enter. He said, strive to enter the narrow gate because few will enter. He said, broad is the gate that leads to destruction. So if you do happen to have the wisdom and the spiritual wisdom to put your hope, faith, and trust in the finished work on the cross, not only did Jesus die, he was sinless, but the penalty for sin is death. You notice he was put in a tomb. He had guards guarding the tomb. The problem, though, for the tomb is Jesus never sinned. So there was no condemnation on him of death because he never sinned. Truth, even crushed to the earth, will rise again, and no lie can live forever. You know, a lot of people say, well, why would I go to hell if I reject Jesus Christ? You're not just rejecting words that sound like Jesus Christ. You're rejecting what Jesus is. What did Jesus say? He said, and here he is resurrecting from the dead. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. So there's one way to eternal life, that's Jesus. So when you reject Jesus, you're rejecting that one way to eternal life. So the way, the truth, and the life, notice the cross is the way. You follow Jesus' teachings. You know, Jesus did say, repent of your sin. Do you know he said that? So there's no such thing as a homosexual Christian. There's no such thing as an atheist Christian. You no longer identify as your sin. You don't do those things. You turn. Repent means to turn from those things. So the cross is a bridge builder to God. Remember, Jesus said, I am the way, the truth. What's the truth? The truth isn't atheism. Atheism's a lie. The truth isn't Islam or Hinduism. That's a lie. There's one truth, Jesus Christ. But he also said he is the life. So you live on eternity. You are now back into fellowship with God. You do not go to hell. You go to heaven. So when you accept Jesus Christ, and you should be begging, you should be running and desperately becoming a Christian. No one should have to talk someone into accepting such a wonderful gift of salvation. Let's get on the motorcycle and ride. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. So when you reject Jesus, you reject the way, the truth, and the life. So let's get started with these seven absurd things that atheists believe in. Here we go. Number one. What's number one here? Atheists are presuppositional atheists. They will say atheism is true until proven otherwise. But atheists, this is a flawed way of approaching things. You need to say atheism is not true until it's proven. Same exact thing with Christianity, Islam, all these things. But you know what happens in debate? When I go up against debate with atheists, it's if you get a piece of paper, draw a line down the middle and put all the proof and evidence on one side for Christianity, for Jesus Christ, for the existence of God, and look at the other side, there is no proof and evidence that atheism is accurate and correct. Matt Dillahunty is famous for failing my challenge, the Shock of God challenge. Aaron Raw, godless engineer, cosmic skeptic, these atheists, Richard Dawkins, they failed the Shock of God challenge. They could not provide proof and evidence that atheism is accurate and correct. Now, there's another problem I'm going to talk to you about. YouTube is ran by non-Christians. I'm going to prove it to you. Every Christian agrees that there's two genders. It's a sin to do this pronoun lameness, right? But if you go to your settings on your YouTube channel, you'll notice it's going to ask what your pronoun is. Why don't you just say male or female? Because YouTube is Antichrist. Now, before you laugh and say, well, yeah, that's YouTube, do you know that Matt Dillahunty, Aaron Raw, cosmic skeptic, godless engineer, the entire cast of the Atheist Experience show, these podcasts, these atheist podcasts that are lame, the Atheist Experience show, The Line, The Hang Up, all these stupid things, do you know that they have bought into this unscientific rebellion to God that you could just come up with your own pronoun? See, as a Christian, we embrace biology. We have respect for it. We have respect for science. But you atheists, you disrespect biology and you disrespect science. You also disrespect common sense. Now, you know we're getting in the last days when even Richard Dawkins says that the whole pronoun thing is silly. There's only two genders. Then why are the atheists community on YouTube saying, well, no, there's more than two genders? Why is Matt Dillahunty, the lame, idiotic Atheist Experience show, also The Line, The Hang Up, all these atheists, why is it that when a man calls in, if he says he's a woman, they'll put she or her just because he says it? Because atheism, ladies and gentlemen, is retarded. It's retarded. Now, we're not going to do this video, the rest of it, on YouTube, because YouTube itself is gay and lame. They have militant homosexuals, trannies, confused people that are confused about their gender. They're into that pronoun stuff. They have these people working at Alphabet Inc., YouTube, Google. And every time I do these videos, they get their little feelings hurt because what I'm saying is truth. There's objective truth. And it's true that there's only two genders. I never thought I'd see the day that Richard Dawkins agrees with me. Now, I guess if you're an atheist on YouTube, you just violate science. So when I take this corner, this video is going to end. We're going to start off with the seven absurd things that atheists believe in. So look in the comment section. See the Rumble link? You need to click that Rumble link before the countdown ends, because this video is going to end in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All right, I'll see you at Rumble. Now, for those of you at Rumble, let's get started real quick. Do this real quick. Welcome to free speech. YouTube doesn't allow free speech, so welcome to free speech. Let's start with number one.